Everybody, sorry about the long time in between videos. Been really, really busy, and I want to go ahead and apologize and say that there's not going to be any gameplay footage in this video. I still haven't figured out how to put in gameplay video on top of my videos by myself yet, but I am trying to learn, so one of these days we'll get it down. So there's been a lot of talk today because the embargo just lifted on Alan Wake, and I was lucky enough to get my hands on an early copy. And I've played the absolute hell out of this game. Alan Wake is about this author that goes to Bright Falls with his wife Alice to kind of help him break this writer's block that he's been going through. Alice ends up going missing, and Alan has to figure out where she is and combat the darkness, or the people that have been taken over by the darkness called the Taken, and he defeats them and takes things over using light. So it is a very light-based dark game, if that makes any sense. Everything's extremely dark. It's like 95% of the game is at night and in the woods. And you are armed with a flashlight, and of course you get other kind of light weapons like flashbangs and flares and a flare gun. And of course you get like a pistol, shotgun, hunting rifle, that kind of stuff. But basically, you are going to be running around shining your flashlight on stuff, because the Taken, who are the bad people that have been taken over by the darkness, can't be harmed unless you pull the darkness out of them. But they're still evil. So you shine your flashlight on them until they kind of burst a little bit to let you know that the darkness is out of them, and then you kill them. There are also items that are taken over by poltergeist darkness, and you do the same thing. You shine your flashlight on them, use a flare, whatever. At least until you just get the darkness out of them, and then it can be harmed. The game really reminds me of Silent Hill, especially the beginning. A lot of fog, just a lot of darkness, you're in the woods. I don't want to give away too much details, because I'm trying to keep this as spoiler-free as possible, but it does remind me of Silent Hill. And I've got to say, this is probably the best Silent Hill-type game we've had since Silent Hill 3. Alan Wake does an excellent job of making sure you're constantly, like, on the edge of your seat. You're constantly panicking and worried and scared. And I found myself a lot of times actually holding my breath, and I wouldn't realize I was holding my breath until I'd killed all the enemies. And it was like, whew, okay, you know, keep going. The game, it got repetitive after a while. It really did. Like, there's only so much you can do running around in the dark in the woods. But every time I kind of started thinking, like, okay, this is getting really repetitive, I'm tired of the woods, the game would completely switch on me. And it would put me in a whole new situation. Maybe it was during the day and I'm in a city or some other locations I can't really give away. So it kept the pace going really well. I did still get tired of the woods, but I think it introduced enough locations, new locations, that were not the woods to keep me interested. The game also did this really smart thing. At first, it pissed me off. Like, I would get all of the batteries for my flashlight, I'd max out my ammo for my guns, and I was ready. Like, I was maxed out on everything. I'm ready to kick some ass. And then something would happen in the game, and everything I'd collected was gone. I had no weapons, no flashlight, I'm running around in the dark in the woods, completely vulnerable. And at first I started getting mad, because they were doing it constantly. As soon as I would be completely armed, they'd take everything away and make me re-find everything. But then it got me thinking, I was like, that's actually really smart. It's a great way to keep the player, you know, on edge and keep the player from getting too powerful. Because one of the big things that can kill a survival horror game is when your character becomes too powerful and you don't fear the bad guys anymore. So I think the taking the weapons away was a pretty good idea. The controls, at first they're a little bit weird. You're going to be throwing like flares when you're trying to run by accident a lot. I did that a whole lot, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be fine. One of the things that did drive me crazy was something super small, is when you pick up a gun you already have, that what was in that gun counts as ammo, but you instantly switch to that gun. So a lot of times you'll pick up like a flare gun, and you're thinking you're about to shoot somebody with a shotgun, you shoot a flare gun, and it's just like, ugh. That was one little small issue I had with it. A few of the other issues is the dialogue's pretty silly, the voice acting's kind of bad. It's not as bad as Heavy Rain, but it's definitely no Uncharted 2 voice acting. Alan Wake is kind of a dick, but that kind of makes him more lovable because he's not the everyman. You know, he's not this great hero that's out to save the day. He's kind of an asshole. And there's times where you kind of don't like him. But I think that adds a whole new like dimension to everything. The story, it was, at first, it was really, really interesting. It was all like, oh my god, what's going on? There's supernatural stuff. You know, my wife's missing. I'm trying to write this book. And so at first it was really cool. But there were just one too many twists and crazy stupid turns. And there'd be times where the game would tell you something. Like, oh, this is what happened. And then hours into it later, it'd be like, oh, wait a second. Remember what we told you 4 hours back? Yeah, it didn't actually happen like that. It happened like this. And they did that way too many times. But it was still entertaining, but it really started to become like an episode of Lost, where you were just kind of giving up on making sense of the story. You're just like, you know what? This story is just making up stuff as it goes. I'm not even going to try to understand. I'm just going to go with it. And that definitely reminded me of an episode of Lost, especially if you guys are watching Lost now. Who the hell knows what's going on? But anyways, we're not here to talk about Lost. But the ending of the story really was just like, what? None of it made sense. There was no closure. It's just like the game kind of spelled things out for you a little bit and then just ended. You know, just done, over. Good luck trying to figure that out. And it just really didn't wrap up anything or answer any questions. So, if you're looking for a great story-driven game, Alan Wake might not live up to your expectations. But as far as delivering a great survival horror experience, Alan Wake definitely lives up to that. I think Alan Wake kind of rebirths the survival horror genre in a way we haven't seen in a while. Especially with the Silent Hill and Resident Evil games. God knows where those are going. But Alan Wake was definitely there. I would love to see this team of at Remedy do a Silent Hill game. I think they could definitely nail it. And overall, I'd have to give Alan Wake an 8 to an 8.5 just because of some of the issues with the controllers were a little bit weird at times, but easy to get around. Dialogue was lacking. Voice acting wasn't good. And the story was kind of meh. So that's why I'd have to give it like an 8 or an 8.5. But everything else was great. Graphics are good, the tension and keeping that high tension and that panic and that sense of fear constantly was good. Overall, I had a great time with the game. It's definitely a game you want to go pick up the day it's released, May 18th, my birthday, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Thanks for watching my Alan Wake review.